Hey guys, I hope you're doing fantastic. This is Dan Duran. In this video, I'm going to show you how to tell whether your Linux machine is being hacked and what can you do about it. So stick around. The first thing that we need to know right away if there's somebody else connected to the computer to see whether you're hacked or not. And for that, it's very easy. You just type in who. Now, if you want to have a little more information about who is actually logged in your computer, then you just type W like that. And as you can see, I'm the only one in this computer. There's nobody logged into my computer. You will be able to see other users, for example, coming from different IP addresses right in here, which is not very good. If something like that happens, you might as well just disconnect from the internet and start troubleshooting to see what is going on. All right, so the next thing you need to know is to know if there's a process or there's an IP address connected to your computer somehow. Maybe there is a CNC or a command and control connection logged into your computer, so let's troubleshoot that. So for that, we're going to do netstat. If you do netstat minus a, then you'll get everything, and this is kind of hard to see whether there is anything in here. Let's do a little more filtering on this netstat. So we're going to do netstat again. In this case, we're going to do n for numerical, and we're also going to do maybe t for tcp and u for udp, and then right here to see if there's a connection established. Perfect. So these are the only two connections that are established to my computer. So you can see 67, port 67, and this is actually my router that is connecting my DHCP connecting to my router. And then you see that there is another one, which is just myself. If you see anything else, like it's foreign IP address, it could be a benign IP address. So let's say Microsoft or any other services out there, but it could also be a bad IP address. And for that, you have to go into VirusTotal. So just type in VirusTotal in here. And VirusTotal is a really good library for anything suspicious or bad IP addresses, or what's called IOCs or indicators of compromise. So in here, what you do is type in the IP address. So for example, I'm going to type in anything. So 45.99.123.10, and we'll see if it's bad or good. So in this case, for example, this IP address is a good IP address. It's green. There is nothing about this, right? So that means that in my case, there's not an established connection to a CNC. Make sure that you check all the IP addresses that could be connected. You can also do netstat on Windows as well as Mac OS. All right, so we can also do netstat listen. So if I put here listen like that to see if there's anything listening from my computer into the outside world or vice versa, you can see that there's nothing going on in here. So that's the next one. So we have determined that there's not a user logged into our computer. That's really good. Then we also determined that there's not a CNC connected to our computer. So that's good. But how about if there was at one point an attack and it's sitting in there? So for that, what we're gonna do is gonna put last on the computer. And this, when you put last in here, it's gonna give you a list of all the connections that have been happening in your computer. So you can see that I rebooted my computer and it's running right now. And it was me, and then me, and me, and me. And then I did another reboot, and so on. So there's no other users, and we can actually check for users. So there's a Kali user in here, and then Dan, right? I have two users in my computer, and we can determine this by typing in users. So in this case, you're only listing your user. However, you can also do it like this. So you can type in nano, right? etc pass WD. And when you do that, then you select all the users in this computer. Now, I have to blur this out just because I don't want you to know what users I have inside of this computer. So make sure you check out all the users, especially the ones that have login. They're able to log into the system. Most of them, like all of them, are going to have something called no login. So make sure that you check out all the other ones. You might have a lot of users in there. All right. So that's the next thing that you need to do. And there you go. Okay, perfect. So now this is a little more painstaking because you can actually check the history for every single user on that list. So I'm going to check the history for the root first. So I'll type in history and then start it from the last bit So this is everything that I've been doing with my root user, as you can see. Then I can actually log in with Sudan, for example. And from here, I'm going to do history. And this is everything that the user Dan has done in the past little bit, right? So if you see anything that is kind of unfamiliar or weird, that is going to set red flags. The next one would be to Cali. And now I'm going to do history on this user, and there's no history. Okay, perfect. So now let's go back to sudo su. We can also do something like last home and the user, so Dan, for example, and then bash history, just to see the commands that this user has done, like that. And then you can see all the different commands Dan has done inside of this terminal. All right, so Q to exit. Now the next one is ftop. So I think, I'm not sure if Kali comes with ftop, but no, it doesn't. So I'm going to install this. There you go. And then type in ftop, and then you just listen, you just wait, right? So you can just stay here and wait for any incoming connections. And as soon as you see them, then you're going to see that your computer is being hacked. So ftop is a really good tool for checking out whether a hacker or some sort of CNC is going to be connecting to your device. Now, if you want to listen to other interfaces, then you can do, for example, IPA, and then you are going to see the WLAN, the ETH1, ETH2, and so on, the low. Okay, so let's do another interface. So ftop, and then I'm going to type in I for interface, WL and zero, no such a device because I made a mistake. Okay, so WL LAN zero, right? There you go. Okay, perfect. We can listen on that, but my computer is not connecting to the wireless. That's your wireless interface. Now, if you want to know what kind of processes are going on in the background, then you can type in top, right? And then you'll see all the process. I don't normally use top too much. I use another one, which is btop. I find it much more attractive, at least. This is btop, and it looks beautiful. I love btop. And it tells you things like, you know, like your CPU, for example. My CPU is running at 5%. My temperature is 57 degrees, and then all the information in here. And you can see, for example, the programs that are running. So, for example, Firefox, and then I have my XRDP, which is my remote connection, my Sorg, and all of the other stuff. Terminator is my shell in here. So if you see anything that it does not look familiar, and most of the time you won't know, because some of these you have no idea what they are. But the thing that you need to look at is who is connected to them. So you can see it should be either Dan or your username and root. And then, for example, in terms of XRDP, it's just the RDP client. You can see that. And then SDDM, of course, is the greeter, and then Kali, and so on. So if you see anything weird in here, then you can terminate it. So for example, I can grab one of these, and then if I type in K, and then it's gonna ask me if I want to kill this process, and then I can just say yes, and then just kill it, right? So that's another way that you can tell whether you've been hacked and how to fix it. Any users that you might have in the background that you find, you can delete them from the terminal. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. So Control C in here, Control L to clean their screen, and then all you have to do is just type in user DEL, so for delete, and then the user. I'm not gonna do this because I don't want to delete my own account, but you can definitely get rid of any accounts that might be in the background. You can do also L soft. It's gonna give you a list of all the commands inside of the system, and this is going to be pretty overwhelming. You can also check processes using PS. So PS and then AXU, for example, and then it's going to list all the processes that have to do with executable commands. The user is the root most of these, right? So then you'll see a couple of them, systemd and then messageD and pulkytd. These are regular processes. There's nothing in here. Everything is looking pretty darn good on my machine. So these are all the ways that you can see whether your Linux box or Linux machine is being hacked. Now, what do you do if the hacker or the malware is actually hitting in there and you have a rootkit that you can't even tell whether there's something in there because you can't make sense of what's going on, or it's not very obvious for you to be able to find out? Then we can actually put a root rootkit analyzer on your Linux box. And the name of the rootkit analyzer is called actually check rootkit, right? So we're going to install that with app install chk rootkit like that. And let's run it, right? So I'm going to run this. There you go. All right, so you see that there's nothing found in here. And sometimes it gives you false positives. So it might say that there's a file or a folder that is suspicious. You should actually check those just in case to see if there is a rootkit in there. If not, just call it a day if you're not infected. So I hope this helped. This is the way that you actually check whether your computer is being infected and how to solve the problems. You can kill the processes, you can delete the users, you can check the history, and you can check the actual connections to suspicious IP addresses, and then you can run a rootkit analyzer to see whether any files or folder are suspicious. I hope this was a very educational, informative, and fun video, and I hope to see you next time. Have a great night.